Elon Musk, the CEO of SpaceX, has warned that the company could go bankrupt by the end of 2022 if it doesn't meet Starship and Starlink milestones that appear to be out of reach because the Raptor production crisis is much worse than it appeared a few weeks ago, according to Musk. In today's episode of Space Chase, we'll find out. Let's get back to today's content. Years of work had led up to this point, and it appeared that the goal of reaching Mars was getting closer. But for the engineers working on the Starship, it was just a small step in a long journey. In a newly leaked email, Musk claimed that after key senior management left the company, SpaceX personnel dug deeper into Raptor production issues and discovered them to be far more serious than previously reported. Nothing in Musk's email suggests that a Raptor production crisis would cause SpaceX more than minor delays. As of 2021, SpaceX is completing an average of one Raptor engine every 2 days and currently has 35 functional engines installed in Starship and Super Heavy booster prototypes in Boca Chica, Texas. At a rate of one engine every 48 hours, SpaceX's Raptor production capabilities are theoretically strong enough to fully outfit a sim. Things start to diverge below the throats of the combustion chamber, the narrow path of the central hourglass light curve, where SpaceX has expanded the Raptor's existing bell nozzle by a factor of 5 or more, while the optimized Raptor vacuum engine is aiming for a specific impulse of approximately V1R vect, which was designed to support early Starship development, has been made more conservative with a specific impulse of only 365 to 370 seconds, reducing engine performance to obtain test engine sooner. Additionally, the Raptor vacuum V1 will have a smaller engine nozzle to avoid flow separation when the engine is fired at sea-level atmospheric pressure. Vacuum engines require such large and unwieldy nozzles to make them as efficient as possible. A rocket engine nozzle directs the flow of superheated, ultra-fast gases to squeeze as much momentum transfer as possible out of available propellant. The lower the surrounding atmosphere's pressure is, the more those gases will expand immediately after leaving the nozzle. This is why rocket exhausts appear to spread and thin out as launch vehicles. Although the engine's closed-cycle design and regeneratively cooled nozzle should apply well to a vacuum design, the real problem comes when it's time to test this kind of engine down on the ground. Although it's fine for the exit pressure to be greater than the ambient pressure, the effects could be catastrophic if the exit pressure is much lower. Elon Musk said that SpaceX hopes to launch its massive Starship rocket into orbit for the first time in January, pending testing and regulatory approval. "We'll do a bunch more tests in December and hopefully launch in January," Musk said at a meeting of the National Academies of Sciences, Engineering, and Medicine Space Studies Board. SpaceX is developing the Starship, a massive next-generation rocket that'll be used to launch cargo and people to the Moon and Mars. At a facility in southern Texas, the company is putting the prototypes through their paces and has already completed several short test flights. The Starship will be fully reusable, according to SpaceX, with both the rocket and its booster capable of landing and being recovered for future flights. SpaceX's Falcon 9 rockets are partially reusable. The boosters can be landed and relaunched on a regular basis, but the rocket's upper portion or stage cannot. The launch of Starship into orbit is the company's next major step forward. The company must first obtain a launch license from the Federal Aviation Administration for the mission, which is expected to be completed by the end of this year after the regulator completes a critical environmental assessment. Musk admitted that he didn't know if the Starship would reach orbit on its first try, but that he's confident that it'll do so in 2022. "We intend to have a high flight rate next year," Musk said. The FAA and SpaceX have officially issued a preliminary environmental assessment, or EA, of SpaceX's South Texas Starship launch plans, which is a rare sign of material progress. Permission to launch Starship and its Super Heavy booster out of the wetlands off the coast of South Texas, which will be the largest and most powerful rocket in spaceflight history when it first launches into orbit, was never going to be easy. The Boca Chica location chosen by SpaceX for its first private launch facilities, originally intended for Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy, but later committed to BFR, is surrounded by sensitive coastal habitats populated by several threatened or endangered species, while also being only a few miles as the crow flies from a city whose temporary population fluctuates from a few thousand to tens of thousands. The draft's reception and analysis, as well as the timing of its release, have received mixed reviews. On the other hand, SpaceX's draft environmental assessment, which was completed with FAA approval and assistance from the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Services, offers several reasons to be optimistic. SpaceX has completed a programmatic environmental assessment in anticipation of the expected environmental review and launch license approval hurdles that orbital South Texas Starship flights will face PEA. Most importantly, if approved, SpaceX's Starbase PA will serve as a foundation or a stepping stone for the company, allowing it to start small and gradually scale up its Boca Chica ambitions in scale and character. SpaceX has proposed a maximum of 23 flight operations per year while Starship is still in development, including up to 20 suborbital Starship test flights and 3 orbital launches as part of Starbase's first dedicated environmental review. SpaceX would enter an operational phase after working out enough kinks for more confident Starship operations, allowing for up to 5 suborbital Starship launches and 5 orbital Starship launches, as well as ship and booster landings back on land after all 10 potential flights. In other words, SpaceX's first jot PA is extremely cautious, requesting approval for a rudimentary concept of operations for orbital Starship flights. A PA and subsequent launch license accepted as is would most likely allow SpaceX to conduct basic Earth orbit launches and 1 or 2 orbital refueling tests per year, for a total of 3 to 5 orbital launches per year. For example, a 5 launch limit would also completely prevent SpaceX from sending a Starship to Mars, the Moon, or even high-energy Earth orbits without using up all of its annual launch allotments in one trip. The proposed draught PA would clearly prevent SpaceX from completing the NASA Human Lander System moon landings, for which it was awarded a contract worth nearly $3 billion. Each HLS Starship moon landing is expected to require between 10 and 16 flights to deliver a depot ship, an HLS lander, and 1,200 tons of fuel to orbit. On the other hand, that's a good thing for SpaceX's chances of building a Starship as soon as possible. Above all, the FAA should find SpaceX's slimmed-down draught PA far easier to accept than a PA that seeks approval for Starship's long-term goals, dozens to hundreds of launches per year, right away. Following the approval of this bare-bones PA, SpaceX will theoretically be able to add to it with additional environmental evaluations, such as increasing the Starship's maximum launch cadence. Of course, the FAA must first turn the first draught PA into a positive environmental assessment before any of the above can happen. SpaceX appears to have a good chance of receiving a finding of no significant effect or FONSI or mitigated FONSI conclusion based on the substance of the draught and accompanying attachments. In contrast, SpaceX started working on that draft in mid-2020, with FAA announcing it in November 2020. According to some estimates, the FAA turned a 3 to 4 month draught release process into a grueling 10 to 15 month ordeal. Given how hard SpaceX is expected to fight for an orbital Starship launch license in South Texas, it's becoming more likely that Starship, Super Heavy, and Starbase will be technically ready for orbital launch tests long before the FAA approves or licenses them. The public has until the middle of October to read and comment on SpaceX's draught PA, after which the FAA and SpaceX will review the feedback and hopefully finish the study. Even if the FAA issued a best-case FONSI in 2 months, clearing Starbase of environmental launch obstacles, it's difficult to imagine the agency approving an orbital Starship launch license or even a one-time experimental permission in the final weeks of 2021. If you haven't already, please subscribe and hit the bell so you don't miss any future videos. Also, please let us know what you think about today's content. Your support motivates us to keep delivering quality content to always improve.